defeated, I would say desecrated.
Right. It was...
Simpler.
This may have been the Big Bang.
It may have, but due to the fact that it was on Earth, I would say it's more like the Holocaust to one person.
Do you remember how Wesley Willis was able to defeat Spider-Man in all timelines?
Are you saying that when he caused nuclear fission in the air with his fist, that went so fast that it broke through the speed of light and caused Spider-Man to feel his blow in all timelines, even the one where he defeated Wesley Willis?
This must have been the point of inflation, where the speed of light was variable.
Right.
Correct.
Absolutely.
That's exactly
absolutely.
What it was.
Same principle applies to what happened with the confrontation with Batman.
You're saying that Batman felt this in all timelines?
Right. Even timelines where they did not exist yet. Batman, I mean, Wesley Willis exists
in
so
all.
So he is a quantum entity.
Yeah, absolutely, yes.
He's beyond that.
He is, yes.
We cannot fathom.
He is truly great.
Now, I feel like you went with the spelling that I used in I whooped Spider-Man's ass here. Were you saying in a similar fashion to how Spider-Man's head hit the ground, bounced, and hit it again?
Yes.
Okay. I went with this. This was to emphasize the and the U was very small because it was like it was the leftover of the
right.
Like it was tracing behind because the was too fast.
Yeah, exactly.
And then the lowercase B was to emphasize that Batman was wearing armor. Wesley Willis hit the armor.
Oh, so that is the thud of
correct.
The...
And then the armor absorbed it slightly. See? Okay. Hit the armor. And then the T is large in scale because of how powerful the actual blow was.
Right.
Okay. Why did you eliminate the T?
When he says, I whooped Batman's ass, listen to the way I say Batman.
It sounds similar to Batman.
Right. Batman is someone who wields a baseball bat. Or...
Are you saying in the game baseball?
Yes. Okay. In the American sport of baseball.
Okay.
Adopted by many other countries. Bat? Do you hear the... Bat.
Did you take it out because we can't hear it because it's in other timelines, even though it's present?
Yes. The T, if I could borrow this real quick.
An entangled property.
Right. The T, if we just draw a little arrow here. Oh.
So does it only change states? It changes state to an apostrophe when... The state changes to a T in another universe.
Right, exactly. So, it is in a state of temporal flux.
You're right. You must be right.
It is perceivable, but it is not tangible.
We may only observe its effects, and we may only view based upon Wesley Willis's work.
And on the macro scale, we assume its effect as well.
Exactly. It is sufficient to say that there is quantum entanglement occurring between B-A-M-A-N-S and T. It is still very much a part of the word, even if it is not presently present.
I see what you're saying. I went with a little more literal definition. Batman being the antagonist here is a bad man, but I said men also too. You know, multiple timelines, men,
right.
Multiple.
Right, exactly, okay. Absolutely.
Went with the Z as a joke. It was a prank. You've been lied to. Now, I said A-S-S, but they look like twos. It's because they're backwards. They're backwards S's.
Calculus.
No. They're backwards S's because snakes... Who are in the Bible is evil, oppose Wesley Willis as he is God. Now, if we want to look at this literally, the snakes here left Batman's ass. They crawled out of it. Could you come here, please? This direction. Out of Batman's ass. When he punched him, the A here is Batman screaming because Satan was leaving his body. And then I feel like it's fair that we just assume this is Wesley Willis's implied suggestion here, his implied suggestion.
Right. Also, it's interesting because I, like, capital letter I, Wesley Willis is immediately showing that there was no mistake about who beat Batman. It was him. It was
I. Was Wesley. It was God.
It was God.
Okay. I see what you're saying. He's asserting dominance in the phrase.
Absolutely. Okay. Immediately.
Okay.
Immediately.
Okay.
There was no mistaking.
Okay.
Whooped. He said, to defeat using one's abilities, Wesley's being almighty.
May I point something out?
Yes.
This is whooped, not whipped.
Right.
I wrote whooped as it is more commonly used, and it is also, it was slang originally. Whether it is defined as a word now, I am not sure. Are you aware of this?
I'm not positive, but considering the fact that this is the correct transliteration of the sound that Wesley Willis emitted, it is a word. What Wesley Willis
it
puts into the ether becomes real.
Whether or not we define it as one?
Exactly.
Okay, I was going to say that it is different because the word whipped,
right,
which would obviously be what this is derived from, is spelled with an I. Lowercase I. Now, I see this as intriguing because this I is the only I in the sentence. It's the only place that Wesley Willis has in the sentence.
Right, exactly.
Is an after effect due to Wesley Willis's presence on Batman and his ass.
Well, I think we need to continue.
We should continue?
We should continue.
For those of you who cannot see what's happening here, I drew this line to demonstrate that in 4 and 5 here, this idea is continued. Wesley Willis's desire for what he wanted to be heard is continued in these two lines. Okay. I will play this song.
Batman thought he was bad. He was a fucking asshole in the first place. He got...
Okay, wait, hold on. Batman? Thought. He was bad.
Now this has implications.
Now, next time we play, we're going to have to rewind because I feel like this line is too important to place next to other lines.
Yeah, absolutely. This was the first thing, and I whooped Spider-Man's ass.
Spider-Man thought he was bad.
Now, Wesley Willis was immediately ethosing his argument of the song with talking about Spider-Man. Now, in this case, this is in the second verse. Maybe since his confrontation with Spider-Man, Wesley Willis had done some introspection and thought that in order for his devout followers, and make no mistake, you are a follower.
Whether you choose to be or not.
Right. Because there's no alternative that does not exist, and we'll talk about that another time. He thought that maybe my followers could understand me better if I give them the lead up to why Batman thought he was bad.
So what you're saying is that previously, when Spider-Man thought he was bad, he proclaimed this first.
Right.
And led more into pathos of his argument. He allowed pathos later, but bring ethos in second, which expanded into pathos sooner than bringing ethos in first and the proclamation in second, as it allows a bridge between the two, and ethos can run without having to merge into pathos.
Right, exactly. So, you know, our first verse was the pathos of the argument. This is now the ethos. The chorus, I whooped Batman's ass, is the logos. That is a fact. That is objective,
right?
Pure fact.
He said it.
It is more than a fact. It is truth.
Definitely, without question. Now, here's what I think is interesting. Wesley Willis has so far in the songs that we have taken apart for the viewer, always used the word thought when referencing the antagonist.
Right. And
the antagonist thought something. Wesley Willis knew.
Yeah.
He knew. He did not think. They thought, and they were wrong. They were wrong. Batman was not bad. Wesley Willis was bad. Batman had a strict moral code, and he still thought he was bad, which was just ignorant. Ignorant. It leads me to believe that Batman lives in an oblivion of his own thought, similar to Spider-Man, unlike Wesley Willis. How do you feel about this?
I would agree. I would think that Batman, as a vigilante who stalks the night, it is very easy to lose one's way.
In the dark. Okay.
Batman, after years, for Wesley Willis, years are nothing. They don't exist. But for a immortal being such as Batman, years are percents of your life, you know. But Batman, for years of fighting criminals in the dark, began to question, is this the right thing? And he thought he was bad. For a time, and unfortunately for Batman, it happened to be during his partnership with Wesley Willis that he thought he... May I borrow this?
Take it.
Batman thought he... was bad.
He's not.
Wesley Willis is bad.
Thank you, sir. I'm going to erase this line now. Would you care to rewind the song slightly?
Absolutely.
Maybe it also has to do with, because Batman thought... There were times where Batman did not consider himself a hero because he's kind of one of those anti-heroes. So maybe he thought that because he has those morality issues that he was having trouble with, maybe that made him think that he was going bad.
I see what you're saying. But I believe that Batman thought he was bad, and maybe it was during one of those times, but it was still during his partnership with Wesley Willis, and that is a line that no one should cross. Batman crossed it, and he faced a punishment.
Well, it may not be that Batman thought he was morally bad. Maybe bad is short for bad ass.
Right, we did discuss this in our previous video, that this could be African-American English.
Even still, I would argue that Batman thinking he was badass is incorrect because Wesley Willis is the most badass, and he can define who is and who isn't badass.
Right.
Spider-Man was not.
Spider-Man most certainly was not. Maybe Batman had the audacity to believe that he could be equal with Wesley Willis, and Wesley Willis had to deign to put...
He said
Batman
no.
in his place. He said
he
no.
He said no, Batman.
We can condense I whooped Batman's ass to no.
He said, I am the badassiest of all of the badasses.
That's right.
Okay. Rewind the song a bit. Rewind the song a bit. We missed the line.
I did.
In the first place. Maybe the ass is an allusion to the prefix bad in the first statement.
Oh, that could be. What was the next line? I have forgotten. The cat distracted me.
Fucking asshole in the first place. He got knocked to the floor.
He got knocked to the floor.
He got knocked to the floor.
You are correct. That is wondrous memory. He was a fucking asshole in the first place.
So,
the first place.
We may have to recant a lot of what we said. The first. I have to change colors.
Take another marker. Take another marker, my friend. My good sir.
First place. First place has the connotation of being initial, prime, a jumping off point, an activation point. It was the origin, it was the alpha. The Big Bang. Perhaps. Perhaps Batman and Wesley Willis existed before time together. And Batman had a different vision. For creation.
Are you saying that the muck could be the sea of chaos that existed before?
Ah! Not.
Not a drug game.
Not a muck or a muck, but a
muck. Like a disgusting muck.
A disgusting muck.
And Batman saw it becoming a healthy place where people lived happily. Wesley Willis said, no, it will be a place with free will.
Right.
Okay. I see what you're saying. And that's why Batman was a fucking asshole.
Right, because
he wanted to take away people's free will before they even had it.
Exactly. And make no mistake, I did mention that perhaps maybe Batman and Wesley Willis existed before time together, but that does not put Batman on equal standing with Wesley Willis.
No, Wesley Willis is clearly the true god.
Right, if they were equals, he wouldn't have whooped Batman's ass.
Batman would be in the band with him.
Right, right. They may have even destroyed each other in such a violent confrontation. But no, Batman is clearly the inferior. He is beneath Wesley Willis, even if he is supremely above us.
But does free will define prosperity? Do we only see Wesley Willis as all-powerful because free will happened to occur?
We see him as all-powerful because it is true. Free will does not cause our seeing of him. Our seeing of him as the god is not related to free will. It is a blatant, obvious truth, as opposed to a result of our creation.
Right. Right, it is a consequence of our existence that Wesley Willis is almighty. Batman wanted to take that away from us before we had a chance to experience it.
And as a result, he was knocked to the floor.
And this is incredible, too, because this ties into the timeline theory. Floor. There were no floors before creation.
Simply a muck.
Simply a muck.
Maybe as a joke, he put fucking here, fuck rhyming with muck.
Right, yeah.
Sense of humor is very obscure.
Yes, Wesley Willis was ahead of his time, pardon the pun.
And notice how he's not saying Batman in these two lines. He's saying he. which suggests a more personal relationship.
Right. Yeah, he's not standing on ceremony with Batman.
He's not formally calling him by his name. He is saying he to describe someone that he knows. Someone
right.
that everyone knows.
Right.
He is important here. I feel like that's about it for these lines.
Right.
It's pretty blatant what is being described.
Indeed. We have a repeat of the chorus.
I don't feel like we need to write anything here as much as describe once again that he is ingraining this in our minds.
And here we get an instrumental break. Now, Wesley Willis is renowned for. It is giving us a break from the chaos that is the cataclysmic event of Wesley Willis fighting someone.
Allowing us to absorb the information for a brief time, as opposed to forcing it down our throats so that we have to go back and listen again. It's a kindness.
Many traits are different. These next lines, I feel, will be very important.
Okay.
Because of the implications.
So many implications. There's too many. We can't cover them all.
No, absolutely not. It's... beat the hell out of me and knocked me to the floor. This is incredible.
I feel like hell is a reference
to
Batman being in hell or Satan possessing Batman here.
Right.
Maybe Batman is Satan.
Perhaps.
Yes. Floor, right? Yeah. Beat the hell out of me. See, this would imply that Batman beating the hell out of Wesley Willis would be the same thing as taking the hell from him. However, in the form of a beating.
Right. Maybe, well, because Wesley Willis is the origin of all and will be the end of all, including hell. Wesley Willis had hell inside of him, and Batman fought him, beat him, and in doing so...
When you say beat, do you mean won, or do you mean just physically beat?
Physically beat, because there is no possible way that Wesley Willis...
He won.
Alright. We know I whooped Batman's ass. We know
Wesley
that...
Wesley Willis won.
Right. At the end of the day, at the beginning of time, Wesley Willis won the confrontation.
Okay.
His name's Cowder. Look at the shoe! He's so I'm sorry. Would you like to
see?
So cute. You
want
to see a picture?
Look at the big fluffer. He's a big shoe. It's more important.
I put in front of the camera.
This is what we're being interrupted for.
This is my aunt's new dog.
It's rape.
Look at the dog.
Jesus Christ.
It's so cute.
It looks like a small pup.
Yes,
I am. How do you feel?
Batman beat the hell out of me and knocked me to the floor.
Yes.
I got back up is the next one. I got back up and knocked him to the floor.
Okay.
And look, right. He's so big.
I feel like this song is less deep in the final words.
I'm so jealous.
Than I beat Spider-Man's. I whooped Spider-Man's ass.
Right.
As he's simply restating what he has already proclaimed.
Right. There is less of a narrative here.
Yeah, it's simply him ingraining, because Batman is more powerful than Spider-Man.
Yeah, absolutely.
Older, wiser, more rich.
Right, it's as you said, Batman's more of a Bruce Wayne, while Spider-Man's more of a Peter Parker.
Exactly.
I would dare say even a Miles Morales.
You are heavenly.
You did it.
My friend.
Hey, that's Wesley Willis.
That's true. He provided you with that ability. I mean, still we should reference, you know, the I, once again, being used to describe Wesley Willis. There are no other I's in this sentence.
And whenever Wesley Willis refers to both himself and Batman, he outnumbers... He refers to himself more times than he refers to someone else.
So as to show just his overwhelming bearing on the situation.
Right.
Once again, he ascended, got back up, and then Batman was descended, or in this case it was Wesley Willis, but with the common theme of ascending and descending.
Right. What comes up must come down, but right. In the case of Wesley Willis, even if it goes down,
it will still come up. We just don't understand why.
No way.
I feel like we can continue the song.
I want Batman's ass! I want Batman's ass! I want Batman's ass! I want Batman's ass! I want Batman's ass!
Got a repeat of the chorus to describe what happened in the end.
I think the implications of him shouting the line is important. You're saying that him shouting the line allows us to understand, like, how deeply he wants us to understand that he whooped Batman's ass. Like, it's more important than Spider-Man's ass. Right. It, very much so. And here, this is interesting. There was a pause.
He paused to describe Batman's ass. Batman's ass is clearly more important than Spider-Man's ass. That's the end of the song. That's all we get.
I've actually seen that.
Shall we play the song for them in its entirety one more time?
We shall. Play it. Don't show the video.
Absolutely. That's private. No one is
in front of the camera.
Batman got on my nerves. He was running me amok. He ridiculed me, calling me a bum. I whooped Batman's ass. 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 Batman thought he was bad. He was a fucking asshole in the first place. He got knocked to the floor. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass. I whooped Batman's ass.
I whooped Batman's ass.
Absolutely.
Our next episode in the series, after this song, will be My Mother Smoked Crack Rocks.
Stay tuned.
And obviously stay tuned for the end of the song. It's not over. We've still got another sequence in which Wesley Willis will describe Batman's side of the fight and once again explain to us who was the victor.
Batman beat the hell out of me and knocked me to the floor. I got back up and knocked him to the floor. He was being such a jackoff. I whooped Batman's ass. 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 Chicago. Wheaties represent champions.
Batman's a fool. What? Who's a damn fool?